Hello everyone, welcome back at Tech ET. Looking back on 2019, one of the best phones to be released was the Huawei P40 Pro. Most people in the US overlooked it due to its lacking availability in the country, but if you did manage to get your hands on the phone, you were treated with gorgeous hardware, insanely capable cameras, and some of the best battery life around. The P30 Pro is still holding its own here in 2020, but its successor is right around the corner. Huawei continues to be in its ongoing feud with the US government, but in spite of that, we are expecting big and exciting things for the new P40 lineup. At first, let's talk about how many models we are expecting in the P40 lineup. This is a series of phones after all, which means that more than one is coming under this umbrella. Starting with the most powerful phone of the series and likely the most popular is the Huawei P40 Pro. This is the proper flagship Huawei is releasing for the first half of 2020, and it's expected to have most impressive specs and highest price. Right behind that is the regular Huawei P40, which is the middle child of the three phones we are expecting. If it's similar to the last year's P30, the P40 will offer a very similar experience to the P40 Pro with a couple of small cards and a more reasonable price. Lastly, we should also get a Huawei P40 Lite. This should be the least powerful and least expensive P40 variant Huawei releases, and it's currently rumored that it will actually just be a rebranded Huawei Nova 6 SE that already exists. In regards to the design Huawei is going with this year, let's first take a look at the regular P40. The front of the P40 appears to have very minimal display bezels, along with the left positions cut out for two front-facing cameras. Around back, there's a rectangular camera bump with the three camera sensors and an LED flash. Moving on to the P40 Pro, it looks very similar. We have the same dual front-facing camera cutout and camera bump, although there's appear to be a fourth sensor below the flash. For both the P40 and P40 Pro, we are expecting USB Type-C for charging and no 3.5mm headphone jack. Let's take a look at the other specs. Camera quality is always a big selling point for Huawei's P lineup, and we're expecting more of that in 2020. The P40 Pro is shaping up to be quite impressive, boasting a 64-megapixel primary camera along with ultra-wide telephoto and time-of-flight sensors. There's some confusion as to whether or not the P40 Pro will have 4 or 5 rear cameras, but we are hoping that gets clarified soon. We don't know much about the regular P40's camera setup, but we should learn more in the coming weeks. Something that we think we'll see on both phones is a 120Hz refresh rate for displays. This is a trend that a lot of Android phone makers are expected to adopt in 2020, and based on that, the latest reports, we think 120Hz panels are likely for the P40 and P40 Pro. When a new Android phone comes out, you expect it to do certain things, such as run all of the various Google apps, services, and have access to the Google Play Store. Unfortunately, that doesn't seem to be the case for P40 or P40 Pro. As a result of the Huawei still being on the United States entity list, the company cannot use any Google tie-ins with its phones. Well, that's all for now. Thank you for watching this video. Don't forget to subscribe this channel to get more updates. Till the next time.